describe yesterday's research we have done. First, we hooked one of our senior brahmacharini, Ma Nitya Supriyananda, in the EEG machine. It's a remote control machine. The scientist, Dr. Kanak Pandey, she is working on the field of neurofeedback. Come on, Supriya.
Up!
Oh. Om. Om Hrim. Om Hrim. Om Hrim. Om Hrim.
The first word she said is unimaginable. I have never seen anything like this in my 26 years of experience. She is the founder member of Indian chapter of ISNR. Her name is Dr. Kanak Pandey.
Myself, I'm Dr. Kanak Pandey. I'm a psychologist by practice and my profession is psychologist. Since 84, I have clinic. Now for last 10 years, we are into neurofeedback and biofeedback. Neurofeedback, again, a brain training system that trains brain for better attainment, for better regularization, because the brain has four ability. Continuous to heal.
So you are in the field of the brain for years.
Yeah.
Wow.
So brain has the natural capability to heal. Even if we don't teach anything, it heals itself. It regulates. And it is changing all the time. And it is improving all the time. That's why children learn to do so many things. Even if we don't do anything, they learn to walk, talk, sing, balance, do very fine things. But in life, with so many things, we lose these plasticity. So we forget to regulate, we forget to again heal, we start becoming sick or ailing or start having poor ability to learn new things. Cognitive abilities are going. So neurofeedback trains brain that thing, and it's an amazing technique the Swami is showing here that is really beyond my capability to understand. I'm trying to, but really I've never seen this type of thing.
And the first study is, normally, when she's normal, how the brain is working, we found she has a brain. Second, it's working normally. Third, when the Kundalini was awakened at the exact moment, the researcher, the scientist, doctor, she says, Swamiji, the awakened state is intensely expressed. Same way, the deep sleep state is also intensely expressed. She says the gamma wave, which goes down very low, like a 1, 2 and all, during sleep, deep sleep, it has gone almost less than 1.42. She says this means there is no outer world information getting processed. The cognition has completely stopped. She says only during the deep sleep or the highly sedative can only create this kind of state. She says if I see only the monitor, I will say she is sleeping. But I can't say that now because I am seeing she is jumping. On the other side, extreme wakefulness. She says that wakefulness and let you guys see the original video of her own explanation. She says, I should not make any technical mistake in technical terms. That's why I'm just briefing you. She says that wakeful state is something extraordinary. She can't even express immediately because she has never seen anything like this. She says the energy level, not just 1000%, 1000 times more. Another important point she says is, when I gave instruction for the Brahmacharini to levitate, she says first the instruction is being processed in the brain. Means the brain is being convinced about the instruction. It is not like a hypnotism or a mesmerism. Straight away bulldozing and it is being executed. No. The negotiation goes on between the instruction and the brain, and brain gets convinced, and then the expression starts happening. She says very clearly the whole thing is.
And if this, the good thing is this, it can be implemented to masses. Ours is 1-to-1. I'll work with 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if
I can actually do for at least 1,000-2,000 people at a time.
So if it can reach to many people, if he's doing for 1,000 people and it just works for 10% people, I'm a scientist, so I'll talk on that percentage basis. Even if it works for 10% people, that will be a great help to society. So finding here is very amazing. Really, we have got the thing, the on baseline and in activation, it has gone up to 1,000 times.
Wow.
1,000 times. Now we need to calibrate.
1,000% or 1,000 times?
1,000 times. So we need to calibrate this with others finding what actually it means. When we have never seen those readings, so we don't know what brain can do if it reaches to that thing. Because beyond our limit, we say only up to this limit. And if you start hearing up to 2 times time, we don't know what you can hear. We don't know, we can't understand that. So if your brain is having capacity of that, we really have to understand what actually you can do. So we need to understand. We can just only predict something or guesswork, a simple guesswork. Okay, I'm doing one. If you attain 2, you will be able to 2. But no, brain is amazing. If you can attain 2, you may be doing 1,000 things. We are very not sure. So we need to see some research work, some other awakening things, and something to understand this data. What I suggest from my experience, that you can calibrate it by experiences. What actually you felt differently when you have attained this. Because you understand your body the best. You understand your brain the best. So what good, what not so good, what very bad you experienced, you thought, and what type of confidence you got, what type of, say, nervousness you got, anything. Just get anything, whatever you get, like mining. When you are digging, you take everything and then analyze. That will help us to contribute to his work, and he'll be able to help us more. Brain normally is recorded in like electricity. It's like electrical impulses we are recording, and they are measured in hertz. So, and the amplitude is the length, the height of the any wave. So one thing is like frequency, how fast they are moving and how high they are going, the strength of it. So when I say delta is very high, it means the amplitude of delta is very high that time. Amplitude is there, delta is there, alpha is there, all the frequencies are there, all the time present, but who is stronger? So delta is very stronger that time and gamma is very low that time. It means a person is sleeping. If I just see the graph, I say person is sleeping and brain is not processing anything. But right here, in front of me, a person is and talking and doing normal thing, still his brain is producing like a shut down everything, not receiving and not processing anything. It's absolutely sthiti pragya. it's not pressing anything. So this type
prajna,
of
ah.
is completely cut off. You are isolated from the outside world, and if outside world can leave you for even a second, you will be something different certainly. Because since the time we take birth, we are always responding to outside world and storing. The moment we are cut off, we are much more than living and dead, both. It's a something different. The waves are defined as processing speed. The slowest wave, like 1-4 times in a second, is the slowest one. 0-4 times is the delta wave, that's the slowest, when brain is not processing anything. And when infant is born, he is having maximum delta in his brain. That's why he is sleeping 23 hours in 24 hours. So only because he is not processing any outside information. So that's the slowest wave. Then theta is like internal processing. You are not receiving things from outside, but internalizing, like creating something, daydreaming. And in active word, that may say as absent-minded. You are here, but you are not here. You are not paying attention to. Then alpha is very relaxed and a learning
that state. Level which you said that internally thinking.
Internally
what was
thinking.
What was that in them?
Theta was high. Initially it was high.
Oh.
It was high initially. Then internal processing was going on.
Okay.
Because certainly a person is awake and aware, and she must be processing what all is going on here. The way we are processing.
What I am saying, from outside information processing is not there.
Afterwards it was not there. Afterwards it was very high. The gamma was very high. Then the processing was not there, even internal.
Oh.
Initially it was high.
Oh, okay. So after that internal also is not there.
No, not there.
Oh, so I can say when I give instruction, it goes and becomes internal. That is the time there was high.
Yes.
Then internal also becomes silent.
Yes. Then alpha is relaxed learning stage, where we are absolutely relaxed and learning new thing and processing. And then the beta or SMR, there's a faster, where you are processing a bit anxious, like you are learning, studying for the. So you are studying, you are paying attention, you are relaxed, but tomorrow is the exam. So a bit of anxiety is there.
What
so
is, where that, how that shows?
Beta.
In
her? No, it was low.
Okay, there
initially,
is no anxiety.
Initially all were high. It was all had gone for very high processing. Everything was high.
Okay, okay.
Then after activation, after few seconds, it's down.
Okay.
And then the gamma is completely, in our term we say it's like a complete brain activation, whole brain activation. The electricity is passing very fast. So either it happens only two times. It's like in psychology we say it's a aha moment, when you are working on some solution and not getting the solution, problem, and you go to sleep. All of a sudden in sleep, during sleep, you get into that gamma where you clue the information, this was the solution. So that's a very high state of awakening, but it's a very gluing, so cut off from everything. Now I'm not processing. Door is closed and I got my solution. Gamma. Two scenario. Gamma is for two. Yes.
What is the waves of the waking state? Usually in everybody.
That may be hardly 10-15 amplitude. Of 15 to 20 is very normal.
In our case?
Hers is 45.
Wow.
It's three
so
times.
Waking state.
Yeah.
Three times.
Yeah, even that. So I'm sure if it's not on body, I'm seeing this as disturbance. Pardon me for saying so.
No.
If it is jumping, she'll not be reading, she'll not be doing all that. If she does some task, I think the retention will be the highest.
Wow.
But then her body has to be settled.
Actually, as per Patanjali, this can very clearly say, I can declare her as enlightened publicly. See, that is what Patanjali means. Samadhi means this only. Nothing else.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say, which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experience.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.